Good morning, my dear student. Today in our class, we are going to learn about the divisibility rule. These rules will actually help us to determine whether a number is divisible by another number without actually carrying out the division process. So let us have a look at the different divisibility rules.
Let us study the rules of divisibility. First rule is divisibility by 2. If the number is even, that is, it ends in 2, 4, 6, 8 or 0. We say that the given number is divisible by 2. For example, 26. The number 26 ends in 6, thus it is divisible by 2. Next rule is divisibility by 3. If the sum of the digits of the number is divisible by 3, we say that the given number is divisible by 3. For example, 384. When we add up all the digits, that is 3 plus 8 plus 4, we get the sum as 15. And we know that the 15 is divisible by 3. So we can say 384 is divisible by 3. Next is divisibility by 4. If the number formed by the last two digits of the given number is divisible by 4, we say that the given number is divisible by 4. For example, 164. Its last two digits form the number 64, which is divisible by 4. Thus, we can say 164 is divisible by 4. Divisibility by 5. If the number ends in 5 or 0, we say that the given number is divisible by 5. For example, 525 ends in 5, thus it is divisible by 5. And the number 330 ends with 0, so it is also divisible by 5. Next is divisibility by 6. If the number is divisible by both 2 and 3, we say that the given number is divisible by 6. For example, 408. If 408 is divisible by 2 and 3 both, so 408 will be divisible by 6 also. So let us check the divisibility by 2. 408 ends in 8, so 408 is divisible by 2. When we add up all the digits, that is 4 plus 0 plus 8, we get 12. And we know 12 is divisible by 3, so 408 is divisible by 3. So we can say 408 is also divisible by 6. Next is divisibility by 8. If the number formed by the last three digits of the given number is divisible by 8, we say that the given number is divisible by 8. For example, 53,888. Its last three digits form the number 888, which is divisible by 8. Thus, 53,888 is divisible by 8. Next is divisibility by 9. If the sum of the digit of the number is divisible by 9, we say that the given number is divisible by 9. For example, let us take the number 729,639. Here, on adding the digits 7 plus 2 plus 9 plus 6 plus 3 plus 9, we get the sum as 36, which is divisible by 9. So we can say 729,639 is also divisible by 9. Next is divisibility by 10. If the number ends in 0, we say that the given number is divisible by 10. For example, 8,620 ends in 0, thus 8,620 is divisible by 10. Next is divisibility by 11. If the difference of the sum of the odd places and sum of the even places is either 0 or the multiple of 11, so we can say that the given number is divisible by 11. For example, let us take the number 7,1,69,308. Here, the numbers at the odd places are 7, 1, 9 and 0. And the numbers at even places are 0, 6, 3 and 8. Find the sum of the odd places and the even places. After finding the sum, we will find the difference of the digit at odd and even places. We get the difference 17 minus 17, which is equals to 0. So, the given number 7,01,69,308 is divisible by 11.
Thank you for watching the video. I hope you understood the concept. Try to do the questions in your rough notebook yourself. See you soon in the next video. Till that time, take care.